Burning fat and building muscle at the same time is absolutely possible, just not at the very nanosecond, right? Like, if you look at it big picture, of course you can. Like, over the course of 7 days, you'll have multiple periods in which you can have anabolic periods, where your body is literally building muscle at that point in time, but also deficits, where your body is burning fat at that period of time. You just can't do it literally at the same second. But upon this whole theory, I realized that what is called a protein-sparing modified fast, which sounds complicated and sounds kind of daunting, that could be something that could be implemented on your rest days to really accelerate fat loss while maintaining your muscle and not allowing you to go into what is called a catabolic muscle wasting phase that you might normally encounter if you're in a caloric deficit. So let's break it down. It's kind of intriguing stuff. Before I get started, down below there is a link to a company called Golden Ratio, and I've talked about them on my channel before. They're awesome. They are, the best way I can describe it is it is like a coffee tea. Okay, so it's a coffee that is a low acid golden coffee that is in a bag like tea. Now, the reason that is unique is because you can travel with it, but it's also very low acid, which is tremendous if you are really watching that kind of thing. It's easier on the stomach, really good if you're doing keto or anything like that. But if you're on any kind of like weight loss or fat loss adventure, like, it makes perfect sense because you can travel with it. It's just, most of all, it's super smooth, and that's what I like about it, but it's just different. I'm always into like new, different kinds of things. And since it's a golden coffee, it's more like a tea. So I can't really describe it other than saying it's like a tea coffee, but it's just, it's wild, and I highly recommend you check it out. There's a link down below to save you a few bucks as well. Golden Ratio has supported this channel for a while, and they are awesome. So use that link down below and check them out. Now, you're gonna think I'm a lunatic for a second, so please hear me out on this, because when I talk about the basics of a protein-sparing modified fast, it sounds ridiculously extreme. And it generally is, okay? It's used in like medical weight loss settings. So I'm not saying you do it all the time. Okay, let me paraphrase kind of what it is. Protein sparing modified fast is where you increase your protein intake with very, very lean protein. So fish, poultry, eggs, egg whites generally, you know, very lean. You're not adding any additional fats, okay? But you're also still having lean veggies and things like that. Or when I say lean veggies, I mean not cooked in oil. It is not something you'd want to follow for a long period of time, by all means. But what ends up happening is you do essentially get yourself into somewhat of a ketogenic state, but you're having enough protein that you are stimulating like huge amounts of insulin via the protein. What is that? Why would I want to stimulate insulin? Because when insulin is stimulated with lean protein, it doesn't spike your insulin in the way you're thinking. It doesn't spike it in terms of like slowing down fat loss. There's this thing called the insulin to glucagon ratio. And when you are spiking your insulin via lean protein, even whey protein shakes will do this, you're also bringing up glucagon. So your insulin-glucagon ratio stays right where it should be, meaning you're still allowing yourself to burn fat at the same time. You're not, even though insulin levels are elevated and you're protecting muscle from breaking down, you're also still allowing fat loss to occur because glucagon is elevated. You need glucagon somewhat elevated to allow fat loss and hormone-sensitive lipase to actually work. So let's break it down what this would kind of look like for you. On a regular weight training day, like, or a workout day, you're going to have an increase in anabolism. Okay, you're going to be much more insulin sensitive. You're going to be able to get more in the way of muscle protein synthesis on your workout day because your cells are going to soak up more. It's just the way that it is. So that would imply that on your rest days, you're not absorbing as much, which in a lot of ways you're not. But the downside is, most of your recovery and actual rebuilding is happening on the next day. So you have a little bit of a disconnect in terms of like what your absorption is postprandial, like after a meal, versus what your actual cellular muscle protein synthesis rate is. Two different things. You can have muscle protein synthesis occurring at the cellular level, but if you're not getting it from your food, what's the point, right? So on the days that you work out, you absorb more. Okay, so you can get by with actually consuming less on the days that you train. Whereas people tend to look at it a little bit differently. They say, I trained today, let me load up on more. There's still a tolerable upper intake. The journal Nutrition published a study that showed that evenly spaced out protein throughout the course of the day is significantly better. It increases muscle protein synthesis by 25% by spacing it out, not by trying to have these boluses of it. So where this comes into play is, you don't need to be focusing as much on having copious amounts of protein on your training days. You're gonna absorb more with less. You actually want to have more protein on your overall rest days. But you don't want to add more protein to a day that you're not working out, because all that's going to do is add more calories, right? You already have your baseline, so you just add more protein. No, you have to compensate somewhere. So what I would recommend is you actually put yourself into a deficit on your non-training days and use those days to go a little bit extreme now and then and do a protein sparing modified fast. And what would that look like? It's gonna look pretty aggressive. You're gonna look at like 1.5 to possibly even 1.8 grams of protein per pound of body weight. Now, I know that's not super extreme, but when you're not consuming anything else, yeah, that's like 12 to 1500-ish calories for a 200 pound person of just protein, lean protein. So before you like tell me that I'm extreme and telling you to do something super low calorie, it's really not ridiculously low calorie. That's a good amount of volume of food. Then you also have calories coming in from veggies, although they're nominal. So you're probably gonna still be in a fair bit, but you'll be in a deficit. That's the point. Okay, we want you to be in a deficit this day, but we want you to do it with protein sparing modified fast, where you have ketone production because you're not consuming any carbs, but you also, you have the protection there, but you also have massive kind of insulin spike from the leucine. Let me break down what an insulin to glucagon ratio looks like for a second and why it's important, okay? Protein spikes our insulin, and that sounds crazy. And I'm gonna use a simple example. If you have a protein shake, like a whey protein shake, your insulin spike is gonna go through the roof. You're gonna have a huge spike in insulin, similar to what if you were to have like a bunch of carbs. That sounds crazy, and it sounds like that would be detrimental. The difference is, if you have a bunch of rice, you're gonna spike your insulin, but you're gonna actually drive glucagon down. Glucagon is responsible for liberating glycogen from our tissue. It's also responsible for liberating fat. So if glucagon is high, you're gonna be liberating, well, carbohydrates into the bloodstream. If you consume carbohydrates, why on earth would your body also want to liberate more carbohydrates from your muscle or from your liver? Like, why would it ever do that, right? So that explains why when you consume carbohydrates, your glucagon levels go down to make sure you don't add extra glucose, because you're trying to absorb, not release. With protein, protein is also very anabolic and is also pro-growth. So when we consume protein, we have to have a spike in insulin so that the protein can go where it's going. The difference with protein is you also have an increase in glucagon, okay? Because now you have insulin that has to bring the protein into the cell, but no glucose, right? So now you have to be able to allow protein into a cell by spiking insulin. And if you didn't release more glucagon, then that would end up meaning that your blood sugar would drop so much, because protein and whatever blood sugar was in the bloodstream went into the cell when insulin was spiked. So in an effort to keep homeostasis, it upregulates glucagon to allow glucose into the bloodstream too. Well, the good news is glucagon is fat burning and keeps you lean. So in this case, protein, we're driving up insulin and glucagon and keeping things right where it needs to be. So that's what it would look like. On a day where you train, eat your normal caloric possible surplus. You need to have surplus, deficit, surplus, deficit, surplus, deficit to allow yourself to be in that net stage that you want to be at the end of the week to burn fat and build muscle at the same time. As always, keep it locked in here on my channel. And remember, this is just an idea. I'm not a doctor, and this isn't what you need to do every day, and it's not what I do every day. But experimenting is fun because it's how we learn. I'll see you tomorrow.